So I'm pretty sure this is going to work even better than I had hoped. What I noticed is that this aluminum lever cap has this nice node on it here, where this one is just this smaller section here. So not only am I now I've got more tension that I can apply here by this knob. Otherwise, this one is just pivoting off of it and locking it. I'm sure this is fine, but I really like the way this is coming about here. So here's my hawk blade. Let me put my blade in. And I want to put this lever cap on top of here and then just get this guy started. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to determine where I need to cut this bolt off. Oh, I got that blade in upside down. Do I? No, I don't. That's right. I just have it set one too many. There. I didn't have it set on the right little node right here. Okay, so what I want to do is I want to determine where this bolt is going to get cut off, so I'm just going to lock it down here. I don't want to go crazy. I don't want to crack the cast iron or anything. Then I'm going to put my lever down, or my tightening knob. Tighten that down, and I'm going to take a Sharpie, and I'm going to reach inside here. And I'm going to just mark it like this so I know where to cut it.
Oh.
I either have to cut a few little shoulders on the top so I can tighten this down with a wrench, or cut a slot in it to tighten it down into the sole of the plane, into that threaded receiver there. So this would work like this. I just don't want this here on my hand while I'm working. I mean, it would work just fine, but I'm going to cut it off right below that concave area of this locking knob, and it'll be out of the way. But see, I haven't altered the original structure of this hand plane one bit. And I was thinking, this thing is pretty well done. I'm not going to really be able to make this work anymore. I mean, I guess I could drill this out and try to rework this, but see the way I've cut this top down over the years. So this is, I got to let it go. I just have to let it go. But I am going to take this and I'm going to cut it right here. I'm going to cut this off, and then I'm going to cut these wings off, and I'm going to make I think I'm going to cut it completely off, or maybe I'll just cut them back like this. I'll cut them back like that. But I actually wanted the blade to sit all the way, to be able to sit edge to edge, like a rabbiting plane. But what I really want is I want to have a chisel plane. So if I cut this off, and then this just comes off the front, and I've got a way that I can lever this down, and I may just use this one to lever it down and use one of the other blades. And so then I've got a way that I can, cut right, clean glue lines and stuff right into corners. I've wanted a chisel plane forever, but the Lee Nilsons are really expensive, and I just kind of have a block against those wood river planes from Woodcraft. Even though they look pretty nice, they have a really beautiful chisel plane. But I think I'm just gonna experiment with this because it can't hurt. So let me go cut this guy off. Okay, so here's the bolt that I cut the top off. I left it maybe just a little bit long, and then I just cut a little slot in it with the hacksaw, kind of shaped it up a little bit, and now I've got a way I can get this, fine screwdriver in here to tighten it down. So let me put it in my block plane here. Pretty unusual to find something seven millimeters. It's not a real common size. So So here's my new post, and here's my angle adjuster. And my hawk blade. Old lever cap and my modified knob. So what I was saying is I like this because I can loosen the tension just a little bit to make my blade adjustment, and then once I get things, you know, I can leave tension on it, but then I can loosen it up just a little bit so there's not so much force on this mechanism and this while I'm trying to make an adjustment, and then I can just tighten it back down. So I really, this is what I'm used to, and so that's why I'm really happy this is the way it's going to work out. But yeah, I'm very pleased with this. And now I'm ready to start wearing the grooves away in the side here. That's nice. It's got the engraving of the model number of the hand plane here, so I'll know when I start wearing into it. But like I said, I don't think this thing was used very much at all. Very nice. Thanks.